respond carefully and cautiously here. I looked at the world the morning after Middleton, and what I saw was 16 acres of ashes in downtown New York City, island of Manhattan. I saw suffered a severe blow. If you looked closely enough on television, see footage of American citizens jumping out windows on the upper stories of the Trade Center because it was better than being burned to death. And I knew for a fact that if we hadn't been successful, if the passengers on Flight 93 hadn't been successful, they probably would also have taken out either the White House or the Capitol. It's the worst attack in the history of the Republic. We lost more people than we did at Pearl Harbor. We had good reason to believe that there would be follow-on attacks. We'd seen attacks in 93 on the World Trade Center in New York, in 95 on our operations in Riyadh, in 96 on Cobalt Towers, in 98 on East Africa's African embassies, and in 2000 on the USS Cole. And now along comes 9/11 in 2001. And there was an accelerating pace of the frequency and of the scope and scale of the attacks. We would have been absolutely totally irresponsible if we hadn't taken the view that we had to do everything in our power in order to prevent that next attack. And that's exactly what we did. Now you can look back at it, and to some extent our success allows some of our fellow citizens to say, oh, it was nothing to worry about. You guys overemphasized how serious it was. Dick Clark was the head of the counterterrorism program in the run-up to 9/11. He obviously missed it. The fact is that we did what we felt we had to do, and if I had it to do all over again, I would do exactly the same thing. I'd be just as tough and aggressive as I could to make certain that those individuals who wished us harm and who were prepared to kill thousands of Americans to achieve a political objective got what they had coming to them. And I think it was the right thing to do. And I don't have much tolerance or patience for those who suggest now the benefit of hindsight 8 years later, and they've forgotten what in fact happened on 9/11. It was the right thing to do. The threat is still out there. We need to maintain our capabilities. It's absolutely essential we not forget what happened then or what others are prepared to do with us. Just imagine what would happen if you had 19 men in the middle of two of our major cities, not armed with airline tickets and box cutters, but with a nuclear weapon or a dose of plague or some other deadly biological instrument. That's the kind of world we live in, and any administration or government that doesn't deal effectively with that threat, I don't think we'd be doing this job.
Traveling to Atlantic City to win a big at the slot machines. And I had to go through security on the way. And I told them at the airport, it's just me. And they were asking me about if I was traveling with any weapons in my luggage. I said no, but I might as well disclose to you right now, I'm traveling with my tooth money. No, sir, it's not a weapon. No, sir. Yes, sir. No, it's not a weapon. It's my tooth mace. I don't know where it goes.